Ever uploaded a design and it came out blurry, messy, or just wrong? You're not alone. I'm gonna fix that for you. In this video, I'm gonna show you how to use Kittl to generate, polish, and export real print-ready designs with AI. No Photoshop, no background cleanup, no resizing headaches, just clean, sharp designs that actually sell. And if you're new here, my name is RJ Martinez. I've been in print on demand for over 8 years, generated over $500,000 in royalties, and created multiple bestsellers. Let's get started. So let's come over here and we're gonna jump into Kittl, okay? I'm gonna have my affiliate link down below in the description. If you wanna check out Kittl, it's down below. But let me dive into detail and show you everything back here as far as how we're gonna create this design, okay? One thing I like to look at is templates. This is a game changer right here. When it comes to anything like this, let's say, for example, let's say cherry, you see the cherry right there, right? Let's just type in like cherry. This is just an example right here. Any of these are clickable and editable, okay? You can make them their own, okay? Now let's say floral, right? Floral. Right, you can see that anything like this is kind of like the niche that we're diving into right now, but anything like related to floral or anything like that would be a good idea. Then you come up here, then you can organize it by, let's say, a t-shirt design. Let's like click on this and then use a template, right? And then you're going to come in there, and as it opens up the template, you can click on any of this. Okay, you can change the style, the fonts, the image, any of that stuff, okay? And you can change the backgrounds, like all that stuff. It's pretty cool. Before we open Kittl, we need a smart idea, because a great design means nothing if no one's searching for it. That's why I start every project with research. I look on Amazon, Etsy, and niche marketplaces. I study what's trending and what people are searching for, saving and buying right now. Trends like Fox Daisy Tulip Floral and Ice Cream Cone Crew are popping up across t-shirts, totes, and even digital planners. If you can spot a trend early and move fast with a tool like Kittl, you can beat the bigger sellers to the market. So pick a niche or an idea that's already getting traction. Then you bring it to life, step by step. Now on Amazon, they give us a BSR. You can see right here, 396, 412. The lower the better, okay? This is big right here because that tells that there's a demand inside of here. And then you wanna create something like this, come up with your own idea, or you create something in here, and then you're giving yourself a better chance because people are searching and buying for this, which is very powerful if you understand that. And you, by looking at these BSRs, they're ranking pretty good over here. There's a decent amount of them that are pretty low. With this one, 167K. So let's go over here to the Ice Cream Crew. You're gonna see that 770K, some of them up in the millions right there. Come down a little bit more. We have a few more in the millions. Now, this one's pretty cool too as well. Now comparing it to the Daisy, right? This seems like there's more of a demand over here. The Foxglove Daisy Tulip Floral. There's more of a demand over here compared to something like this over here, right? So it seems like the flowers are popping off more compared to the ice cream over here. All right, as I come over here and click on new project, it's gonna bring us over here into the Kittl editor. Now, we're gonna come over here to the left side, then we're gonna come all the way down to the Kittl AI. We're gonna go ahead and we're gonna click on the image generator. And now with this image generator, it's pretty cool because we can do a lot right here. So we can click, there's Ideogram, there's ChatGPT Image 1 HD, Flux 1.1, DALL-E 3, Turbo. So there's a few different things right here. One of my favorite ones to use is Ideogram, okay? It's fun to use, okay? I've been using it for a while. What we're gonna do is describe an image, and we have the concept already, right? So let's go ahead and do, and if unaware, you can just do a Google search to get an idea of the different flowers or see what they're exactly what they are. So you can see that as we're doing this, I'm just doing a Google search and it's populating the image for us. Let's come over here. Let's come into your hair. Let's say, let's paste that. Let's just keep it real simple as possible. Foxglove, let's say a flower. Make sure that AI gets the concept back here, and then we'll go ahead and generate image, and then we'll go down the whole list. Daisy, tulip, and then Kittl and Ideogram are going to go ahead and generate these images for us. Okay, so I did this. Now let me go back a little bit. Let's see what we can do. Look, and this says for reference. You see what they're doing here? It's more of like that. It's like a graphic style, like cartoonish style. That's realistic, I want to say, but let's come over here. This is more of a realistic photo, right? And that's okay. Let's go back. Let's go over here. I have a few myself for the styles, and you click that, you see how that populates. There's different clip art style, mascot, cartoon. I have cartoon art. Let's go ahead and generate that one. Let's make this a little bit smaller and generate a new one. Now, it went ahead and generated one right here, but we're missing the top. I'm going to go ahead and generate another one until we get it correctly. Okay, now keep in mind, like with AI and leveraging AI, you have to get an idea. You just got to make sure you're doing everything correctly. AI is not going to do the whole job for you, but it's going to get a good amount of it done for you, right? And you want to leverage that, and we're leveraging that as best as possible to give us ideas. And then also, you can see right here, it generates with Kittl, it gives you more ideas over here. Okay, so when you're generating something and you look over here on the left side, it's giving you more inspiration. Different, look at that butterfly, that's cool, right? Look at that dragon, so that's cool. So there's these different concepts, different ideas that you can come over here and look at, right? So this one, pretty decent. Let's go ahead and generate one more, just in case. That one's not bad either. Okay, so we're just getting some different ideas, different elements, putting it all together. You can see what I'm doing here with the artboard. You see what I did right there. Now let's go ahead and generate some daisies over here. So let's get a daisy. Let's just get a feel for it, kind of idea. Let's look and using Google, going back and forth. Let's go back, daisy. Let's just leave it as a daisy. Pretty sure it'll get the concept, get the idea. And if you're getting value out of this so far, make sure you guys smash that like button. Any questions or concerns, leave a comment down below. And if you haven't subscribed to my channel, subscribe to my channel, hit that notification bell. All right, it's giving us some ideas. This one's okay. Let me go back. Let's say like a daisy flower. Okay. I'm liking this one. All right. Now we'll go ahead and do a tulip. We'll just leave it as a flower because it seems to be the one for me. This is pretty. This is all right. That one's all right. I like it. It's okay. Let's try Dolly 3. Let's see what happens over here. It's not understanding us right there for some reason. So this tulip looks pretty good. Let me go ahead and erase this guy right here. And now remember, on the right-hand side, you can upscale. If I wanted to upscale the image, you can do that on the right-hand side over here. I think this is good right here. Sometimes you need to just take a little step back. I feel like these two are pretty good. This one looks a little bit different from the image because we're leveraging AI. You know what, too? I'm just thinking right now, let me just go ahead and like download. Go ahead and download this one, right? You can export it. And then let's come back over here to the image generator, and then you can upload your own style, right? Which is that style. So we'll upload that style so we can mimic that style as much as possible. Okay, which is cool because you're trying to get that same kind of that same style across the whole board, especially if you have multiple images like this. So let's go ahead and let's do that. Upload it, generate. So it read the actual style, the style that we want. Let's go ahead and populate and see what happens. I'm liking it. Like, it doesn't have to be one tulip, right? Let me do like a few of them. Let's go back one more time. I like what we're doing here. Let's do a quick, and you can remember, you can do a quick export of any of the designs here, which is cool because you see what we're doing right there. Let me add that to, and it removed the background for us too, which is really nice for both of them. Let's see if it gets that one. It actually made the same one. Ah, I like it. Let's go ahead and remove the background on that one. Remember, you can vectorize it too if you want to do that, but we'll go ahead and remove the background, and then we'll go ahead and upscale it. Bam. Let's get you in here. Now, let's say you want to make something up here because this flower, the tulip looks exactly, it's kind of like the same color scheme over here. So you can do, that's what I'm saying. You can do different color themes. There's probably all kinds of different types of tulips and daisies, and you can see foxglove. There's a few different ones, right? Different colors. So it all depends on you. Like, it's a personal preference here, I think. What's your favorite color? What do you want to do? So now we're going to go ahead and add in the text, right? I want like more of that script style font, I'm thinking right here. Just trying to keep the style the same, right? The text and the font the same size. All right, now let's say if you want to come back over here and you want to add like a hummingbird or a butterfly flying in the air concept, right? So you can add more to it. So what else can you do? What else can you do here?
Let's click on that botanical theme. Okay, let's click on this one right here. Now, as is, if you don't want to add anything right now and you're saying you're okay with it, this is the cool thing about this. You can download, come over here. This all depends on you. So like where you're, whatever, you can mess with the width. Let's say if I'm going to upload it to Amazon Merch, I'm going to do the 45 by 54 and then the DPI, but you can mess with the DPI back here too. I'm putting about 300 and then I'm going to hit, I can remove the background and hit download. Bam, you can see what we created. Okay, pretty cool. So it populated for us. And then remember, if you even want to just want to change the daisy the same color as the foxglove and the tulip, you can do that by uploading the actual image to keep the reference going right there. So like this one, for example, let's say you wanted to add it in here somewhere, something like that. I'm just trying to figure out where I would put something like that at. But you get the concept. It's like, what else can you do? Let's say we're going to do a hummingbird. Okay, let's generate that one, see what happens. Nice. Okay, let me go ahead and remove this background. That's cool. Let's say you didn't want to put that one. You want to just take out the butterfly. Or if you want to leave it in there, you can. It's all up to you. But just adding some different concepts. But I think that one's really cool like that too. So if you love hummingbirds, you want to create a design, you want to add a little bit more to it, you can do that. It's creating some really cool stuff. But I think this design is pretty much done. But you can see what we did. Went through the whole thing. You see all the elements we created, which is really cool. It does take a little bit of time understanding the concept and the idea and then trying to make it all work together. Exactly what I did right there. Boom.
So you learn how to spot trends through smart research, generate high converting designs in Kittl using AI, clean them up with a background remover, upscaler, and vectorizer, even teach you how to generate an image with the brand style on the back end so you can keep the same concept through the whole design. This exact process I use to launch products that sell. Now you can do it too. So do me a favor, hit that like button, subscribe to my channel if you haven't subscribed with notifications on, and drop a comment. What niche are you designing for right now? If you want to see how I leverage Kittl to create more designs, watch this video right here next. Thank you very much for watching. Peace out.